So here we are.
We've never been invited to play the Grand Ole Opry, but we've been here for shows.
Yeah.
You see it right there.
Yeah, look at that.
So to the Grand Ole Opry, thanks for thinking of us.
Four-time Grammy winners, 10-time Dove Award winners, making their Grand Ole Opry debut for King and Country.
Head to Jim and he will check us in. Hey, that rhymes.
Welcome.
It's a complex moment for us, our Opry debut, because we have already some really monumental memories here, which is just magical, by the way.
We have played this stage for award shows or Christmas shows. This is what it's like. We've been dating, and tonight we got married.
Growing up in Australia, you know, it was
a lot of poisonous animals.
There's a lot of insects, a lot of death around. But we were fortunate to not get, you know, bitten by the spider or the snake.
We're from Sydney, Australia. Born and somewhat raised, moved to Brisbane, Australia, and then straight across the pond to Nashville, Tennessee.
Here we are, 30 years later, we're still here. And we came over here basically penniless, probably the most difficult financial time of our life. And that was the start of the children learning to work together. Cleaning houses, mowing lawns, raking leaves.
It's interesting reflecting on your childhood because in some cases it becomes a little bit like a movie in your memory because you just remember the special things.
Music in their lives has played a big part in their foundation. That's all they've ever known, really, from when they were babes in arms.
Our dad was involved in music, particularly on the business side in Australia.
I'm a manager. I manage for King Country, and I own a third of the band.
We grew up, some of our first memories were going to concerts and to shows. So music, we often say music sort of chose us in some ways even more than we chose music. We fell in love with it.
Here it is.
I think this is actually my room. Luke, I think.
I'll be in the other one.
Yeah, you go to dressing room five. The throne is here, so see, I'm the king, he's the country, so just.
What I have appreciated about country music, there's a community here. To be invited to come to the country music church, the Grand Ole Opry.
Hmm.
And we played the Ryman quite a few times.
Well, well, well.
Here we are. Live at the Ryman.
Live at the Ryman, the first ever, my friends.
The Ryman, you know, that's a sacred place. And as you know, that's got a spiritual heritage. You guys inviting us to come to the Grand Ole Opry, it feels like coming home, and we feel like we're with family.
Great.
I like this one. I like this one more.
No,
why don't you do that?
Mine. No, this one's gonna be mine.
There's a throne in the other one.
That would seem appropriate for you.
How are you?
Good.
Up a little more of the piano. Too, if I could. Ask you quick fingers over there.
It's amazing that you can love me like I, love me like
I. All right, let's hold it there. That's great. I could take my word back on the bass.
I pray that this will be a special night. And that we'll enjoy playing music for these people. We love you. Grateful for these moments. In Jesus' name. Amen.
The reason why we do music is for King and for country, for people. And so even tonight when they announce, you know, please welcome for their Opry debut for King and Country, it's always a keen reminder of the reason why we do music.
It's amazing that you can.
Taking our music to a wider audience. The goal is to share this extraordinary message of hope to as many people as possible.
This album has really been an album, amongst other things, celebrating family. Looking back at what our parents went through at about
our age in migrating from Australia to America, and just sort of the epic story that it was. And so our hope was that it was a launching pad for us and for our listeners and hopefully the world. Love me like I am.
The Opry debut of For King and Country.